Hello, good morning all. Today in this video we are going to discuss regarding how to configure Odoo15 with Pycharm community edition for Odoo development and Odoo debugging. So prior to following this video, the prerequisites are you should have a Odoo15 source code downloaded from Odoo GitHub. Either you can go to GitHub/Odoo and you can manually download Odoo15 source code, or you can using Git clone the Odoo15 source code. So assume that we already have downloaded the Odoo15 code. So if I go to directories, here you can see I have Odoo15 source code here, which I have cloned. So what I have done is here I have already created a folder called 15.0, and here you can see I have Odoo code which is cloned from GitHub. So what you have to do is that you can create a new folder called 15.0 and just clone the Odoo source code from the GitHub repository. So that I have already done. Now let's see how we can open this Odoo15 in Pycharm. So here I will go to my Pycharm community edition. So yet if you haven't installed this Pycharm community edition, you can follow the video that I have added in the description so that you can see how to download and install Pycharm from the scratch. So here I have already Odoo14 which is configured with Pycharm. Now what I will do is that I'll go to file and then I will click on open. So what we are going to do is that we are going to load Odoo15 inside the Pycharm. So I'll click on file, then click on open. Here you can see the corresponding folder that we have seen here. This is 15.0. So what I will do, I'll simply click on 15.0, click on OK. Then they will ask whether we have to open in the same window or new window. So for now, I'll keep in this window itself. So here you can see Odoo15 has been loaded. That is, the folder 15.0 has been loading into Pycharm. Here you can see the indexing is in progress, and I have already also downloaded the enterprise source code from GitHub and I have added it here, and I have added a couple of folders. So you can ignore the other folders, like you can ignore Confancy. In your case, you will have only like 15.0, then you will have an Odoo folder. So right now what we have done, we have loaded 15.0 into Pycharm. The next step is to you have to configure Odoo configuration file. So you can, what you have to do, just create, right click here, create a new directory, give the name as conf. So that's already we have done, and click on OK. Then a configuration folder will be getting created. So I have already done that. So simply I have to keep all the Odoo configuration file in a single place. I have added a folder called conf, and inside this configuration file we'll be adding Odoo configuration file. So this is currently the Odoo source code which we will not untouch. We will keep it as it is, and we will not make any changes inside the Odoo source code. This is the Odoo source code, and I will not make any change inside that. So we will make changes inside outside, like we will create a folder called conf and we will be adding configuration file, and for placing custom add-ons we will be creating a separate folder called custom. So, or I will just rename it as custom. So this is my custom folder, custom add-ons path. So I'll name it as custom. So what we have done is we have loaded the folder, then we have to create a configuration file. So in order to create a configuration file, to get a sample inside Odoo source code, you can go to Debian folder, and here you have odoo.conf file, a sample configuration file from which you can copy a sample. So I have already added a configuration file here which is copied from here, and I have made few modifications. So if I open my configuration file, here you can see I have specified the add-ons path. So my add-ons path for this project is inside Odoo source code. You can see a folder called add-ons. So simply right click on that and click on copy path, and you have to put it here. That is the add-ons path. Then you can set an admin password to control the access. Like you can just set a admin password. This is called as master password of Odoo instance. You can set it as admin123, something like that. You can set admin password. DB host you can set as localhost. This is some maximum connection 64. my DB password is Odoo and database user is Odoo14. So I'll be explaining about how to create a database user in a separate video, and I'll be adding it to the description section so that you can copy that to create a DB user. So my current database user is Odoo14 and I have the given the database password as Odoo and HTTP port like 8015. So I'm saying that I need to access Odoo in port 8015. So if you didn't specify any port here, Odoo will be accessible in 8069. So right now I'm saying I have to access Odoo in browser with port number 8015. So these are the minimum things that you have to configure inside the configuration file, that is addons path, host is localhost. Then you have to create a DB user, and there is no correct order, you can give in any order. DB user I have created as Odoo14 and DB password is Odoo and DB port is 5432 and HTTP port 8015. So we have done with the configuration file. So next step is we have to make some configuration in Pycharm. So what you have to do, you have to come here, click on edit configuration. So here I have already added this thing, so let me remove this. So let me remove, I'll keep this. Okay, so I have removed that one. So when you are coming, it will be something like this. What I can say, edit configuration, you'll have, I need to remove this, apply, okay. So I just deleted the existing configuration that I have already added. So in your case, it will be like this. So you have open the Odoo source code here, created a folder called conf, added the configuration file, then click on run, click on edit configuration, then click on this plus button and click on Python, and you can give a name like Odoo15. You can give a name Odoo15, or you can give any name as it is according to your Odoo project. You can give a name, then script path. So we have to make some configuration here. So I have given the name as Odoo15, then I have to choose the script path. So the script path is, you have to navigate to 15, then to your Odoo, then here you can see a Odoo bin, you have to choose this. So this is the script path, and in the parameter you have to set like this -c, like you have to specify the conf path to the configuration file, -c conf slash odoo.conf, because I'll tell you, I'll give like this, and environment variables and Python interpreter, I'll choose Python 3.8. So make sure that you are running in Python 3.8 or above for Odoo15. So better to go with Python 3.8. So I choose Python 3.8, click on apply and click on OK. So you can see the configuration has been added, and you can see the configuration file is inside conf, that is conf slash odoo.conf. That's what I have given here, conf slash odoo.conf, and the working directory. So you have to set the working directory as the main folder 15.0, click on OK. I have updated that, click on OK. So the steps are done, that is we have opened 15.0 project in Pycharm, downloaded or cloned Odoo source code, created a folder called conf, created a odoo.conf file and set the necessary parameters in it, and we have added the configuration here. Now you can see how 15.0 here, from here you can restart service, you can stop the service, you can stop and start the service. Now you can see running on 8015. Now you can go to browser and just you can enter localhost 8015, or you can enter 0 like this, you can enter, and if you click on enter, you can see Odoo will be loading. So here you can see these are the database that I have already created. In your case, you will not have any database, so you can create database using the create database option, and here you can see during creating a database, it will ask us for a master password. So this master password is what we are setting here in the configuration file, that is admin password in the configuration file is the master password for database operations like create, restore and deleting a DB. So this is how we can configure Odoo15 with Pycharm community edition. So I'll be adding in the description section about how to configure or how to install PyCharm from scratch, and also about how to create a database user for Odoo instance. So that's it for this video. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask in the comment section or connect us in social medias like LinkedIn, Facebook and Twitter. So that's it for the day. Have a nice day. Thank you.